Hi, I'm Dr. Jim Hovind of Ramos Law and your host for Health Matters. This time, we're talking about light. Did you know that there can be an effect on your health and healing from the type of light and how much you get? Well, there is, and I'm going to tell you about it next. After an injury, or in life in general, one of the main things that helps us heal is the type, amount, and quality of rest that we get. Especially when it comes to our sleep. If we're not sleeping enough, it causes havoc on our body's ability to rebound and to heal. And if you've been through any sort of trauma, physical trauma, that doubles down on your body's ability to heal if you're not getting sleep, right? You just can't do it right. So I'm gonna share something with you really cool that I had never heard until I was studying the messages of a PhD. His name is Andrew Huberman. He has this incredible podcast called The Huberman Lab that you can check out. But I'm gonna give you a boiled down essence of a really important principle on the connection between sunlight and sleeping. Now, if we just talked about if you sleep well, you heal well. And there's lots of reasons for that. But without going into depth, let's talk about how that transitions to light. Did you know that when you first wake up in the morning, your body wants to have a clock that gets set on when it should start to get going and when it should start to shut down? There's these photoreceptors in the eye that go to the brain, and it starts winding down the process. So think of it this way. If you get up and you keep the curtains shut and you don't get any light and you're just kind of laying there for a long time, it delays your body clock of when you should start shutting down at the end of the day. Seems weird, right? But check this out. What the research has shown, and if you want to see the research, go to the Huberman Lab podcast and look at, I think it's episode 2 or something, or 2 or 3, that talk about this in detail where you can see all the reference papers. But if you get up in the morning and you go out into the outdoors, whether it's bright light, overcast light, as long as it's after the sun has come up, you are going to stimulate these photoreceptors in your eye that are going to tell the brain, okay, start the countdown for rest. In about 16 hours from now, I think it's about time to go to sleep. Now, the reason that's important is if we don't get enough sleep, we start messing with our dopamine levels and some of our feel-good chemicals, and it can lead to increased tension, increased feeling of a lack of well-being, and even move towards depression. It also leads to a lack of our ability to manage stress correctly. And you know that innately, right? All of us do. When we're not sleeping well, innately we don't feel well. So by getting light in our eyes, so if you go outside, it doesn't mean that you have to be staring at the sun. We don't want that. But just moving around in the outdoors at whatever the light conditions are, between 5 and 30 minutes, depending on what time of year it is, where you live, how cloudy is it, but just going for a walk. Just going for a simple walk, being out without glasses, taking that light in, it's gonna help you start to wind down at the end of the day. It's gonna help you rest better. It's gonna make your feel-good chemicals stay balanced in part with the other things that we've talked about, and it's gonna help your healing. So I hope this answers a little bit of information about light and sleep as sleep affects healing. Try it. In fact, if you have questions about it so we can go into more depth, you can email me, jim@ramoslaw.com, and we can talk through it deeper. But try this for 3 weeks. Just do it for 3 weeks, get up and go outside, just go for a walk, and then see how you feel. Now, if you want to take the most advantage of light, you'll do that at the beginning of the day, and then slightly before the sun goes down, before you can't see it anymore, go out at that time of the day too, and that then accelerates the body's internal clock of saying, okay, almost time to sleep. And it winds it down that way. So now you're getting the best of both worlds. Oh, one quick bonus point. Look to stay away from any light, blue light, yellow light, doesn't matter the spectrum, between 11 p.m. and 4 a.m. because your body's not meant to be looking at light at that time. Now, I know there's shift workers out there watching this. There are exceptions to how you manage this, which again, you can find in that podcast. But look to stay away from light from 11 p.m. to 4 a.m. And that's gonna have a really good effect on, because if you're watching, looking at light of any amount during that time, it can really accentuate the bad stuff of not getting enough sleep. So I hope that helps. If you did like this, or if it spurred questions in your mind, please send it to others, share it. You can find us all over the place, subscribe to our channels. I appreciate you. And just remember, your health matters.